Hi, welcome to another episode of Block Talk. I'm Chris, and today I'm going to walk you through a couple of demos that I think highlight some interesting patterns that we see from our partners and customers. Oftentimes we get questions from our partners and customers asking, how do I take ledger information? How do I take my ledger data and push that to a backend system, an existing backend system, like maybe a SQL database? In today's example, we're going to show you two different variations on the same theme. We're going to show you how to take ledger data and push that into a Postgres database or push that data into a MySQL database. There are variations on the theme in that the Postgres example is going to look at contract events itself, so emit events from a contract. The MySQL version is going to actually monitor service bus or event grid. And then based on those events, send the information to a MySQL database. Let's go ahead and look at the logic apps that we've put together to create this example. So you see here on the screen, I have my Postgres example, and it's super simple, super straightforward. I have a Ethereum Logic App that you can get from the Logic App Marketplace that's connected to my ledger. It's monitoring that ledger for smart contract events. Again, these are emit events in my Solidity contract. When I get one of those events, I'm going to go ahead and go query that contract, get contract state, and then I'm going to use an Azure function to take that state and turn it into a SQL statement to push that into a Postgres database. Now let's look at the MySQL version. It's the exact same flow, but again with a slightly different trigger pattern. Meaning, instead of just looking at contract and contract emit events, I can also look at things like a service bus or an event grid. This is fairly common use case for backend systems that just publish data to a service bus and expect other applications to take action on it. In this example, I'm monitoring a service bus from Azure Blockchain Workbench, and I'm parsing that service bus message to make sure it's a message I'm interested in. Again, this is all optional from a user standpoint, but once I do find a message I'm interested in, we do the exact same pattern we did with a Postgres example. We go query a deployed contract, get all of its current state, and then push that information as a SQL statement into a MySQL database. So let's go ahead and let's work through that demo just a little bit so you can see what's going on here. Here you have, I'm using Workbench so that it's sort of easier and nicer to see the UI, my interaction with a contract. Because I'm using the Logic Apps, I'm not really tied to Workbench. I can use any Ethereum-based RPC endpoint to contract and monitor, or contact and monitor. But let's go ahead and take a couple of actions on this contract. I have a deployed contract. I will take one action here, which is sort of the first contract function. We'll just go ahead and transfer responsibility of an asset. Now, when I hit, or when I complete this action here, and I hit take action and submit, a number of things are happening, right? So right now that contract and those events are being submitted to the blockchain. The event is being mined and added to the block. That information comes back here, but then what's also going on right now in the background is these logic app flows are being triggered. I'm going through and looking, getting notified when an event happened, getting that information and pushing it to Postgres or MySQL. Let's go ahead and look, for example, now in our Postgres database. So let me just go ahead and select everything from that ledger or from that account. And let's go ahead and query our database. And you see here, I've added a single row to this database, but I've added a row based on the contract information, right? I have the participating parties. I also have state, right? So I've gone from my initial state into my first state. It means I've transferred responsibility to a new party. Let's go ahead and look now at the MySQL version, and it's going to look exactly the same, right? Again, the SQL underlying SQL behavior is the same. I'm just using two different databases, but you see here again various counterparties, various information, and I've just entered the same state into the database. Now let's go ahead and take one more action. Again, the scenario here is I want to record what's going on in my contract so backend systems can do that. Let's go ahead and take one last action. Let's finish off this particular contract. And now that that's completed, let's just go ahead and look at the MySQL example, because again, they're both the same. So we'll just take a look at one. Let's go ahead and reissue the same query command, select all from my table. And you see here, I have that second entry, right? So now I have sort of this running history of states and running record of what's happening. So that was it. This code and all of the setup and walkthrough is on our blockchain dev kit GitHub page. You can go ahead and set all this up and sort of help build this very simple, but I think powerful example. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe or follow us on Twitter at MSFT Blockchain.